once upon a future time in a place called Stardust Bay. Counting down to adventure now. Rockets on a mission, we're on our way. Space racers, surfing the solar winds. Space racers, together the fun begins. Way out where the planets, moons, and stars all shimmer, shine, shine. Having a great time exploring space racers.
Hey, wait for me!
If Gosling doesn't get here soon, he's going to miss the run.
He'll get here, dear. You know how responsible he is.
Come on, we're going to be late for class.
Where have you been, son?
Just around. Sorry I'm late.
Who can tell me the distance between Mars and our moon?
And if you ever find yourself lost in space, two major constellations can help you find your way home. Ursa Major and Cassiopeia.
I see you found my old fuel testing device. It looks like you made a few modifications.
I'm sorry. I didn't think... I'll clean up and go now.
No worries. I like what you did with it. Sun's about to come up, though. Won't someone be wondering where you are?
Huh? I didn't realize I'll miss my run. But I have to put everything back.
And no worries. I'd like to run a few experiments myself on your tracks. Never tried one this, long and complicated. You go on now.
Gee, thanks, sir.
And if you will notice this diagram right here, which is why it's so important to know exactly how much fuel you have at all times. You must have enough to get there and back, wherever there is.
I always bring a lot. Fueling up is my favorite thing.
Hey, who needs to worry about fuel? The faster you are, the less fuel you need, right? And I'm the fastest rocket in the academy.
Says you.
Yeah, says me.
Class, Raven is wrong. You do have to worry about fuel. Does anyone know why? Anyone? How about you, Gosling?
Sir, there's no one in this class named Gosling.
Well, maybe not in class, but there is a Gosling outside the hangar, right? So, Gosling, does going faster mean you need less fuel?
No, sir. That wouldn't be accurate.
Continue, please.
Well, sir, the faster you go, the more fuel you burn up. So you need a bit more than if you go slow. It's a little more complicated than that, but...
Very good! You know, you should be taking this class. In fact, maybe you should be teaching it.
No, sir. I have some work to do. Sorry to interrupt you.
What work does he have to do? Isn't he in school?
No, Gosling is a freighter. He transports and delivers supplies.
A freighter? What does he know about space racing?
Hey, you're Gosling, right?
Oh, yes. And you're Eagle, fastest cadet in the school.
Yeah, Well, most of the time. I was just wondering, what are you looking at?
Oh, nothing. I mean, well, we need to do some work on the lunar elevator. I was just calculating the distance between the Earth and the Moon.
Can't you just fly up to the Moon and measure it that way?
Well, yes, but that wouldn't be scientific. What if you had to measure something and you couldn't fly there?
But we can fly anywhere.
Yeah, but what about when you're exploring some place for the first time? If you don't know how far it is, how can you figure out how much fuel to carry?
Oh, good point. It's that fuel thing again. Can you teach me how to do it? Figure out the distance, I mean?
Sure. So, look up. First, you draw an imaginary line between the moon and the sun.
I mean, that kid Gosling is smart. Like, really smart.
Then how come he's a freighter?
Just because he's a freighter doesn't mean he can't also be smart.
Well, he'll never be a racer. He doesn't have the shape for it.
Sorry, I just thought it was funny. I mean, deciding what you're going to be based on your shape. Look at me!
Hawk is right. Shape doesn't matter.
Yeah, everyone should be able to do anything they want.
You know, when I was your age, I wanted to be a space racer.
You?
Yes, me. But in school, I discovered I really like building and testing things. The flying stuff, not so much. That's why I ended up in my workshop doing what I love. Teaching you.
So why can't Gosling go to school to find out what he's good at? Maybe he shouldn't be working as a freighter after all.
Wow, I'm getting full.
Well, I'm traveling light. I want to be back in time for tonight's Captain Cosmos show.
Don't travel too light, Raven. We need exactly 222 kilos to make it safely to Jupiter and back.
Nah, I'm only packing 200. I'll just fly faster. Less fuel, lighter rocket, faster speed.
Hey, don't you remember what Gosling said? How flying faster doesn't mean you need less fuel?
I think I know a thing or two about fueling up. Come on, time for blast off!
Booster rockets!
Engage!
Wings!
Down!
Space visors!
Down!
Blast off! Okay, slowpokes, see you on the moons of Jupiter!
Show off.
Can't beat us.
Hey, wait for me!
Raven, what are you doing out here? Why didn't you land yet?
Ava must have miscalculated. She says I don't have enough fuel left to land, take off, and get back home.
You're really in trouble, Raven.
And no way. I'll just head for the nearest refueling station. Ava, plot a course, please.
The closest refueling station is too far away for you to reach with the fuel you have left.
Ava, please sound a distress call.
Roger that, Eagle. Mayday, mayday, Stardust Bay, we have a problem.
Yes, Ava, please report.
Cadet Raven is low on fuel. He cannot return to Earth.
Well, there's nothing like running out of fuel to teach a rocket a lesson.
Whom shall we send to refuel him?
I think I have just the rocket. Gosling, I have a job for you.
Yes, sir. Absolutely, sir. How can I help?
Raven doesn't have enough fuel to finish his run. He thought he could go faster by carrying less fuel.
Oh, gosh, sir. That wasn't very scientific. Less fuel won't make you fly faster.
You know that, and I know that. But Raven didn't. He's currently in orbit around one of Jupiter's moons. I'd like you to go refuel him.
Me? Isn't that a job for a refueling rocket?
They're, all busy at the moment.
Okay. I'll have to refuel first, though. I'll need exactly 333 kilos for us both to have enough to land safely on Earth.
Well, what are you waiting for, Gosling? Get moving!
Yes, sir. Okay, you're a go for landing.
Thanks, Gosling.
Just doing my job, Raven. I'll follow you in.
No problems?
No, sir.
You had enough fuel for both of you?
Yes, sir.
Nice figuring. You know, you'd make a great engineer if you were interested, or even a scientist.
Interested?
Gosling, are you all right? We heard there was some trouble.
How are you, son?
I'm fine. Mom, Dad, I'd like you to meet Professor Coot.
Oh, we're honored.
Well, I'm honored to meet you, Mr. and Mrs. Goose. Your family is well respected here at the Academy.
Thank you.
You know, I was just telling your boy here, I've been noticing his interest in science and math. He might make an excellent cadet if he wanted to enroll in the Academy.
That's okay, Professor. I'm really happy being a freighter. If it's good enough for my mom and dad, it's, you know, good enough for me.
Oh, that's a shame. Because while you were gone, Coot suggested that if you wanted to enroll here, you could take some advanced science courses.
With me?
We thought it was a great idea, but if you're not interested...
I'm interested!
Ready?
Ready. 3, 2, 1, blast off!
Huh? I guess we used too much fuel that time.
Professor, you can't jump to conclusions without running the numbers. That just isn't scientific.
You're right, Gosling, my boy. It may not be scientific, but it sure is beautiful.